Hi, Mr. Sheldon Gomes. First, let me say it's a pleasure to meet you. I've heard about you all of my life from my father, and it's a pleasure to meet you in person. It must be a pleasure for you to be here at a reunion where you played against a lot of and played with a lot of these guys.
Yes, I'm happy to be here, and also I'm happy to know that you are the son of someone who has known me, you know. And one thing my father taught me in life is to be humble, you know, no matter how good you are, you know. Always remember where you come from, you know. And this is a lesson I hope that all the top players, you know, in the Caribbean, you know, will understand, you know.
To be here today and to reflect on everything that you know, what is it like now being a former Trinidad and Tobago cricketer, you know, to come and mix and mingle?
Well, like my father, I'm a people person, and the clubs that are here, like Queen's Park, you know, Crompton, Preysal, even Paragon. I've played for a number of those clubs too, you know, Queen's Park, played for Paragon, played for Clark Road, and the team called Flamingos, you know. And nearly all the players in Trinidad and during my time, you know, being how I was brought up by my dad, you know, they appreciate me, you know, and I'm very happy for that, you know. The same way I show all of them respect, you know, they show me respect too.
You're being honored today, you know, for your contribution to Trinidad and Tobago cricket, a phenomenal contribution, appreciated by so many. I come from the deep, deep south lands of Princestown, and as I told you, you know, my dad used to watch you in Guarakara Park. What's it like to feel to be honored today by the Past Cricketer Society?
Again, I'm happy to be honored, you know, and like. The person that I am, again, I always talk about the person that I am, you know, being humble, you know. There are so many people, you know, who deserve the honor, and yet, you know, they chose me, you know. It is really a privilege and an honor to be here with all those guys who I know, who I played against, and, you know, I mean, we were enemies on the field, but after the game, you know, we were best of friends, you know. And cricket has taught me a lot of things, and one of those things is discipline, how to be a team player. You know, and again, you have to be humble. You know, playing against all those top players, you know, it teaches you a lesson. You know that, you know, no matter how where you come from, I'm a little country boy from Arima. You know, there's always room at the top. You know, once you perform and once you take your practice seriously.
My dad used to call you the best man to have never played for the West Indies. Is when you look back on your career, is it still a little bit irky sometimes?
Not irk me, you know, like during my time, they could have selected three West Indies team, you know. Fortunately, I was there at that time. There was only one time that I thought, you know, I should have been on a West Indies team, and I'm being honest. Like in 78, when the Packer guys went, when they took the West Indies team players, you know, with Packer, and then they were selecting a team to go to India. The year before, I topped the Chelsea batting average, and when they were selecting the team, I scored two centuries against Barbados and Guyana, you know, with Colin Croft from Guyana and Sylvester Clark in there. And then I was having a phenomenal year. And then, you know, of course, I always leave room for disappointment. And what happened is that I was not selected, you know, but I was happy for those who were selected. And I was unhappy that I was not selected. You know?
When you look at the state of cricket now, I mean, you played so many years ago and so much has happened, so much has changed. When you look at the state of cricket now, West Indies and Trinidad and Tobago, what's it like for you to watch cricket now?
That's a tough question because for me, the state of cricket right now, you know, it's very disheartening, you know, because West Indies have been a team that was at the top for many, many, many years. But I mean, I am going to talk because, you know, I'm not in the game anymore, you know. I find that, you know, the board, they are not, I'm talking about the selection panel, I'm talking about even the cricket board. I don't think that they're doing the right thing in selecting the best team. You know, we have players who have been omitted, and, you know, it is sad, you know, because if you want to win, you know, you have to select the best possible team. And it, right now, for me, I believe it is in a sad state of affairs. So much so that I tell you, I want to get rid of everybody. No, I'm not being honest, you know. because I love to look at cricket, you know, and when I go to cricket and I see the performance, you know, there are players who should not be on the team, but they are on the team, and there are players who should be on the team and they are not on the team. I won't call no names, but I think everybody knows that.
Mr. Gomes, a pleasure doing this interview with you. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that. Have a good day. Thank you.